Okay, so now I'm going to tell you about where I worked. I came to Delhi only last year, and before I was in Delhi, I used to work in a place called Vellore. Vellore is in Tamil Nadu, it's in southern India. There is a medical college there, and I studied there and I taught there until I came here. And what I studied there was complex interactions between diarrhea and growth. So if you look at these two children illustrated here, the little girl is 2.8 years old and she is the right size for her age. The little boy is almost 4 years old. He's the same size as her, but he's actually stunted. But if you were to look at them without knowing what they were supposed to be, you would think they are fine. And this is the problem of chronic malnutrition. We don't recognize it because kids look fine. The fact that this child is 10 centimeters shorter than he should be, we don't recognize until we know both his age and his expected height. So what we've been working on is, what is it that you need to do to make sure that children grow the way they are supposed to? Diarrheal disease is one component of that, but we also work on water, sanitation, vaccines, a number of other things to ensure that children grow the way they are supposed to grow. Okay, the place that I work is Vellore, which is in northern Tamil Nadu. I have what is called a demographic surveillance area. This is a population of 150,000 people that we follow. This is the map of where these people live. It's both urban and rural. And we contact these families at least twice a year to see how they are doing. And when we do studies, we do the studies in this particular community. Now, the overall area that we cover is 57 square kilometers, and this is both rural and urban, about two-thirds urban and one-third rural. And if you look at the families, we know a lot about these families. So we know what their family structure is. Are they nuclear families? Are they joint families? Do they have grandparents living with them? How many people stay in one room? What is the size of their house? Is it their own house? Have they rented it? What do they own? Do they have a telephone? Do they have a refrigerator? Do they own vehicles? And, you know, when I first started out, you used to measure socioeconomic status by asking, do you have a steel cupboard in your house or not? Because steel cupboards was when you were climbing up the social ladder. Now we ask about washing machine. Is your washing machine an automatic washing machine or a semi-automatic washing machine? So, you know, the assessment of how people live has changed in the last 20 years. Now we also ask them, where do you go for healthcare? Our interest is in health, so we need to know this. And most of them, over 50%, even in these very poor neighborhoods, go to private practitioners. And this is expensive because a private practitioner you need to pay for. And this is despite the fact that Tamil Nadu has a good government healthcare system. But the convenience of the private practitioner being available to you when you want them is what determines where people go. And despite the fact that people have lots of washing machines, they don't actually have a lot of toilets. So in our population, one third of the people are using open fields for defecation. And this is data from last year. So, you know, despite Swachh Bharat, there are still a lot of things that we need to be doing.